Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Hello, my name is Eric Spiffy, and today we're gonna be talking about books. Because reading is fundamental. I don't think I've ever reviewed a book here on my channel, which is crazy. I've been on this channel now for 6 years, and you would think that I would have reviewed at least one book, but I will be very upfront with y'all. I was never a reader in high school, and I was barely a reader in college. I was definitely the skimmer, you know, like looking down the articles or looking down a book and being like, information, highlight. Where's the little like, you know, side tab that has like the definition of a word? I was definitely that person in college. Not proud of it, but I've come to love books. And I think that books are amazing. And over the summer, I read 7 of them, which is like, I haven't done that in a while, which is crazy. But I'm gonna be talking about 7 books that I have currently finished over the summertime. If you are somebody who is looking for self-help books, if you're looking for how to be a better storyteller, how to grab people's attention, career books, and just amazing, just fictional stories, then please keep on watching this video because I'm gonna be talking about some of my favorite books that I have recently finished and that I love and that I can proudly say I have read them. They're on my bookshelf. My bookshelf is slowly filling up. Feels great personally as someone who was not a reader. So if you want to know what books I have recently finished over the summer, then please keep on watching. As always, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on Instagram. Before we even move forward, follow me on Instagram if you're not already on there. I will have a link down below in the description box, but please, it's just Eric Spiffy. Simple as that. All right, so I have my little handy dandy notes here because I want to treat this like as if it was like my favorites video, like a makeup favorites or beauty favorites video. So I have some notes here. Don't get mad at me. Don't hate on me if I butcher a book review. This is my first book review here on my channel, but I really want to talk about these because they're amazing. All right, so the first book that I have is Contagious, Why Things Catch On. No, this is not a COVID-19 book at all. I bought this over the summer, and when I saw the title of it, I immediately was like, they're gonna think this is a freaking COVID-19 book, but no, it's not. It's about selling something, selling a product, selling an idea, being a better storyteller, and how to grab people's attention, basically, and how to like get things to spread, not COVID related, but ideas and products. You get the idea. So this is by Jonah Berger, professor at the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania. Hello, hey, I'm in Pennsylvania too, but he's probably very far away. So he basically taught a course called Contagious, and it was so popular that he eventually wrote his own book and came out with it. So basically this book has 6 principles to follow by, and they're key principles called steps with 2 P's. So it goes down the list of, you know, what each letter means. If you're somebody who wants to be a better content creator, somebody who wants to be a better storyteller, somebody who wants to just basically grab people's attention and just kind of make it out there, just being an all-around amazing content creator, I think this book is perfect for you. There are a lot of great examples in here, a lot of different studies and research that he has put into this. First book done. After reading Contagious, the author Jonah Berger, his mentor was Chip Heath. Now Chip and his brother Dan came out with a book before Contagious, and Contagious is kind of based off of Made to Stick by Chip Heath and Dan Heath. So a lot of the same ideas of the basic principles, the 6 basic principles, are kind of sourcing from this book here. So I was like, you know what, I finished Contagious, I want to see where Jonah got his mindset of writing his book, and their acronym is SUCCESS. So SUCCESS basically follows 6 basic principles, and each chapter is basically going down what each letter means. So basically the same thing, the same idea, but also different examples, different research, different studies. Definitely I recommend these 2 books. I will forever probably have these. All right, so the next book, this is kind of funny because, you know, this is definitely, I guess, the job now, basically what I'm doing. So this is the book Influencer, Building Your Personal Brand in the Age of Social Media. And this is by Brittany Hennessy. So it is, I love this little hashtag. It's really pretty. So I picked this up after I read these 2 books, and it was in the same section. And Brittany Hennessy, she is a senior director of influencer strategy and talent partnerships with a digital version of Hearst Magazines. Wait, hold on, let me get that right. The senior director of influencer strategy and talent partnerships at Hearst Magazines Digital Media. So she works with like Elle, Cosmopolitan, 17 Magazine. She has a lot of insight as to like what the industry is like. And so there are a lot of tips and tricks and hints for people that are beginners, intermediates, or professional influencers. And so she breaks down a lot of helpful advice. And what I love about this book is that she brings in also outside sources, so other influencers that have, you know, made it big. And one of my favorite ones is Tenny Panosian, who is in this book. Tenny is one of my favorite influencers. So when I saw that she was gonna be featured in this book, I was like, I need to grab this. I need to read her little chapter, her little feature. It's very, very helpful for somebody who, you know, wants to make it out there, make it big. And so there are four parts in the book. Let me get my note. It's building your community, packaging your brand, monetizing your influence, and planning your future. So like I said, if you're somebody who really just wants to just be an amazing influencer and kind of just understanding the ins and outs of the industry, she talks about everything in this book and it's so helpful. I just want to be like an influencer, you know, like that's like the dream job. All right, so one of my favorite books that I've had for a while, but I finally finished it. This is For Today I Am a Boy by Kim Fu. When I bought this book 4 years ago, this was around the time that I came out as non-binary. And so books about gender identity and just self-discovery, they've always intrigued me. So it basically talks about a young boy who realizes that they are a girl. And it talks about the Chinese culture and the expectations that a young boy has compared to the females in their life. The young boy's name is Peter. He grows up with three other sisters. There's a lot of dark parts of, you know, him realizing that he is a she, and she, you know, is going through so many different things of boys and men and the work life and also dealing with the family. And it just, there's a lot of beautiful dark moments, and it's emotional throughout the entire experience of like her going through wanting to wear certain pieces of clothing or wanting someone to look at her a certain way. So I related a lot to this book. I'm not doing it justice by giving you this horrible book review, but if you are somebody who loves books about gender identity, I would say definitely pick up this book. It is amazing. I'm gonna get better at these book reviews. Just give me like a couple more shots, okay? On the more lighter side, we're gonna be talking about The Misadventures of Awkward Black Girl by Issa Rae. First off, that title, just everything about it is relatable. I am that person who is just awkward, insecure. Oh, and speaking of insecure, she is the creator of HBO's Insecure. And so whenever I saw that she had a book, I was like, I need to grab this. I need to read it, because her humor in the show is just something that's just like I vibe with, you know? She is a funny writer. And so just getting more insight like in her life, it's just an amazing story. And Issa talks about everything you could think of, like family, boys, puberty, hair, you know, work life, and just all of the awkward moments that she has experienced. And so I love that she is very upfront about a lot of things that has happened in her life. And it's just a really funny light read. Yes, just a yes. All right, so the next book that I wanna talk about is a personal favorite and also a personal friend. This is Bright Burning Stars by AK Small. She is a personal friend of mine. She came out with this book almost 2 years ago, I wanna say. I remember going to the book launch party and it was so much fun. Bright Burning Stars is basically about two young women who are at the Paris Opera Ballet School. It's a very prestigious ballet school. So if you're somebody who is a dancer, if you're somebody who has a young daughter, if you're somebody who is a young woman, I think this book would be perfect for you. It's a really great story of these two girls and the struggles that they face with boys and the expectations of the ballet school, and dealing with so many things that a young woman would be dealing with. And I think that it is a beautiful story, and I think, Angela, you did a great job on this book. I enjoyed reading it, and the banter that the two girls had with each other and also with the other figures that are in this book. The ending got me. I was not expecting the ending, and it just took a turn that I was like, whoa. I highly recommend it. I think it's a very beautiful story. And again, Angela, love you, and I think you did really good. All right, and so the final book that I want to talk about, before we do, actually, I want to talk about a very dark time that I had. Which led me to reading this book. And I have started reading self-help books recently, and I think that they are amazing. I think if you're not going to therapy, or if you are going to therapy, it helps you to kind of understand, you know, certain things that are maybe in your way or why you do certain things. And so I was going through a very dark time with heavy drinking. I've since then learned to understand what triggers me to drink, what triggers me to go into a weird bender. And so that is something that I am dealing with constantly. And so I wanted to better understand why I do what I do. This is the book, The Power of Habit, and it's Why We Do What We Do in Life and in Business. This is by Charles Duhigg, Duhigg. I'm gonna butcher that. I'm so sorry to the author of this book. But Charles Duhigg wrote this book. There are a lot of great examples, scientific experiments in this book. He did a lot of research with this, but it's a three-part book. So the first part is habits of individuals. And then the second part is habits of successful businesses and organizations. And then the last part is habits in society. And so I really resonated, of course, with the habits in individuals. And I wanted to better understand what triggers me, why I have certain habits, and how I can reshape those habits, you know, because a habit never goes away. You can always just reshape it. But it has definitely helped me to kind of understand more of myself. And then if you're somebody who is the businessman and wants to understand more of the business side, I think there are a lot of great scientific experiments in the business part. And he talks about so many different companies. I mean, just so many. It's a really great book. So if you're looking for something that's going to help you with your own habits or what triggers you, then I would highly recommend this book. It's been helpful. I'm just gonna say that. All right, everyone, that completes my first ever book review here on my channel. I am so excited and so proud of myself for finishing this many books because I did not think that I was gonna read this much, but I did, and I'm really proud of it. So I'm gonna set a goal to read 8 books. I'm gonna beat it by one. For the fall. So 8 books in total before December 20th or December 22nd. I think I can do it. I'm currently reading 2 books right now. I'm really excited what I am going to be reading. And if you recommend anything for me to read, please let me know down below in the comments. And also too, tell me what you're reading, because I'm curious to know if you have any favorite books, what you're currently reading, what you recommend for me to read. Tell me all of that. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram. I will have the link down below. And give this video a thumbs up. I love you all so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!